I'm going to ask David Weiss to come up and introduce our next inductee.
Thank you. Thank you. Good morning, everybody. It is my honor to introduce the next Star Award recipient. Roger Williams has served the private education sector for over 30 years. For the last 24 years, Roger has been Executive Director of the Accrediting Council for Continuing Education and Training, ACET. I recently read an internal ACET memorandum from Roger. Towards the end of this memo, Roger wrote, and I quote, "The proprietary sector and all of the national accrediting agencies have faced a cresting wave of bad publicity over the past few years. The Senate subcommittee will be in session, and accreditation will be in sharp focus. The errors of the past, whether intentional or circumstantial, have left their mark, and only time and the determination to move forward will carry us through this period. There are no shortcuts." That memo was from June 15th, 1990. Deja vu. That period of time had a lasting impact on Roger, and he has led ACET with the highest level of degree of integrity and an unwavering adherence to the standards that guide and shape an ACET-accredited school. Since that time, Roger has become extremely well-known. Well, let's face it, he's basically famous in the accrediting world and around various federal and state agencies. He has left his imprint on many of the most controversial issues confronting higher education accreditation. And sometimes that impact looks an awfully lot like his shoe. While we are appreciative of his national efforts, CAPPS in our sector in California owe a special debt to Roger for his long and continuous efforts to reason and debate with our state legislative and regulatory officials, state attorney general representatives, and others who often sought to portray national accreditation and its institutions as inferior and often unethical counterweights to regional accreditation agencies. When the going got ugly, Roger got going out to California whenever we asked. He braced the lions in their den and walked out, sometimes without a win or even a draw, but he left a lasting impression that ultimately resulting in approval via accreditation that is now state law. We could not have done that without standing on the shoulders of many, including our national accreditors, often led by Roger. With no further ado, let me ask Roger J. Williams to come forward and receive his star.
Thank you, David. Thank you, Board, Robert, and all of you. I've been coming to many of these meetings over the last 15 years or so. I don't go to many of these meetings, actually. I come to two. CAPPS is one, and the Northwest Association is the other. Not because I don't respect other associations, but I frankly don't have time, and I have to prioritize. And CAPPS has always been one of my priorities. I hold it in great respect. I've met so many people here who I feel like I've come to know better, and who I feel really believe in proprietary education as a quality-oriented sector, and not the one that it so often gets depicted at. Like Roy, I started in the classroom, and over the period of 11 years, I ran school, a vo-tech. And in fact, when I left it, I was still occasionally in the classroom, which if you're ever uncertain about your work, you should get back to the classroom for a little bit as a reminder of just how central that is to everything that we do. Accreditation for me has been a great love over the last couple of weeks, of course, with Steve Jobs dying. I'm sure, seen his speech before Stanford University back in 2005, and the word passion comes up over and over again in everything that he did, and I hope it comes up for all of you. It has certainly been a fortunate focus for myself. And when I discovered accreditation, which was right after leaving George Washington University and spinning it off because it obviously was not in a comfortable home there, I discovered that without accreditation, you didn't have Title IV. This was what's called an awakening. And so in a period that would never take place today of all of 2.5 months, I took this school and got it accredited. Today, you can't imagine getting accredited in less than a year at the very least. But it was a real eye-opener because accreditation for me when I discovered it, which I'd never seen at the university over the 5 years I'd been there, was like this great process of people like myself running a school that were involved in it, engaged in it, and really what brought it to life. That it wasn't simply a bureaucratic process, it wasn't one that was detached from the day-to-day operation of our institutions, which is really what breathes life into it. People, I think, often forget, or perhaps don't value as much as it should be valued, the contributions that go into accreditation by volunteers, which is its essence, ultimately the leadership of the commission itself. These are people just like you who really believe in this process and who have to make very tough judgments. Accreditation is not something that you can simply pay your money and get your ticket. It is something that has to be earned every day. And the Accrediting Commission, to its great credit, and I say this because I know mine personally, are people who really are committed and are competent and really believe in the process. And so for ASSET, when we trademarked, which was a surprise to many people because I'm basically the anti-marketer, the expression "a partnership for quality" way back when, probably 15 years ago now, it struck me then as it strikes me now, and I hope that it strikes you all as well, that ultimately is what accreditation is meant to be. It is not a badge that you stick on your shoulder. It is a process that when you embrace it, you cannot help but to be better. And while you're doing it, you should make sure that your accrediting agency is embracing it as much as you're embracing it. Because it's a process that requires you to be vigilant in maintaining the vision, the mission of those agencies in conjunction with our schools to really ensure that each day we make our students' lives better. Thank you very much.
Take a picture over here. Join me one more time in a round of applause for our award recipients this morning.